Hi, my name is Krishnav Roy. I'm from Mumbai and I'm currently in the final year of my graduation and I'm pursuing honors in economics from Ruya College. I went for my global volunteer exchange to Ivanovo in Russia in the summer of 2015. After my first year, I had like a break of 2 months and I was looking for internships and, you know, different sort of activities to do in this time period. So I was searching online when I came across an opportunity like this about AIESEC basically. So the selection process was like, went on for a week and I browsed through different opportunities out there. I applied to different places. I gave interviews with a lot of countries like China, Malaysia, and in Russia as well. And finally, like this particular opportunity was something that I found the most interesting. I mean, it enabled me to deal with children, and that is something that I am good at, and that's why I decided to take that up. So naturally, I think the first thing that anyone who takes up this opportunity does is search the city they're going to on Google. So I searched the entire history of Ivanovo, like what it's known for, what it's famous for, how far is it from the major cities of Russia and everything. Like, people were actually surprised, how do you already know so much about our country? So the very first thing that happened when I reached, like when I arrived at the Moscow airport was I couldn't find any signs written in English. I mean, they were all completely in Russian, and it took me like a while to, you know, actually adjust myself that, okay, I'm in a completely new land. And but the airport authorities and everything were pretty helpful, and it was not very difficult to like figure my way out of the airport. People have that perception that Russians are supposed to be like not very approachable or anything, but I didn't feel that way. I mean, they knew that I was a foreigner, and people over there, like at the metro stations, at the parks, at the shops, were very, very like helpful as to like, they did not understand English, which is why I had to like completely use my phone to translate everything and show them as to like, this is what I want and things like that. But like the attitude of the people was really good. I mean, I never felt that I'm like completely different or like a hostile country that way. So the biggest challenge that I faced, not just in my work but actually like while living there, was obviously the language. I mean, Russians do not understand English at all, and only like the younger generation of Russians is actually making an effort to learn English, but otherwise language was a huge problem. But that is something that I learned to deal with like over time. I in fact learned the Russian language a bit myself, and coming to my work, I had to conduct workshops for students at a school over there. So there were three different classes. So as the topic of the workshop was the same for all these three classes, we had to curate it differently for different groups of people. So usually like we didn't face much difficulty with the senior class because they understood English first of all, and a lot of them were actually like had taken English as a second subject, so we could get whatever we wanted to, you know, get across pretty easily. But the challenges we faced were with the younger children, because even the teachers, their own teachers did not know English. So the senior students from the like higher classes, they acted as translators for us. So we used to like tell them in English and they used to translate it into Russian and then convey the message across to students. Initially, the students were hostile and not very willing. They were in fact kind of scared of us because we were not like the same skin color as them. But over time, like after maybe like a week or 10 days, they used to await our classes. I mean, the moment we used to step into the school, they used to run towards us, you know, they used to hug us and they used to like take to the classes. And that was a really amazing feeling. Yes, I mean, I did think about doing this in India, but then I realized that in India, I can do it at any given point of time. I mean, I'm getting 2 months at a stretch, so why not do something different? Why not take up an opportunity that doesn't come by that easily? So earlier, I was a rather reserved person, did not like interact with people much. I was very introverted, but this experience like allowed me, like I had to force myself to actually go and talk to people to get things done. Secondly, it allowed me to discover myself. It allowed me to discover what I want, what are the things that I don't like, what are the things am I good at. Within these 6 weeks, I realized a lot of things about myself that I had not known earlier, which is why I've become a lot more self-aware as a person. And obviously, like I can deal with challenges much better. So in some way, I even became solution oriented.